Welcome back. Our third item today is a consideration of an affirmative instrument, and we will have evidence session with Cabinet Secretary. The instrument we're looking at today is the Community Care Personal Care and Nursing Care Scotland Amendment Regulations 2022, and a welcome to the committee, the Cabinet Secretary for Health and Social Care, Humza Yousaf. Good morning. And accompanying the Cabinet Secretary, we have his officials, Marianne Barker, the Unit Head of Adult Social Care Charging, Ian Golightly, Policy Manager for Adult Social Care Charging, and Claire Thomas, the Policy Manager for Adult Social Care Charging, all from the Scottish Government. Good morning, Cabinet Secretary. I believe you have a statement on the instrument.
Good morning, Convener. I hope you and committee members are keeping safe and keeping well. Thanks so much for the opportunity to speak to the committee today regarding the proposed amendments to the Community Care, Personal Care, Nursing Care Scotland Regulations 2002. I'm sure you and the committee are very aware that these are the kind of routine annual increases to the rates for free personal and nursing care. These payments help to cover the cost of those services for self-funding adults in residential care. Historically, these payments have increased in line with inflation, however, are very clear from emerging evidence, including from the Scottish Care Home Census, that the cost of providing care has increased. To help redress this, last year we made an above inflation increase to the rates of payment, 7.5%, a significant increase on the inflationary rate previously used. We again feel it's appropriate to make an above inflation increase to the rates this year, and the regulations before you propose a 10% uplift for 22-23. This will mean the weekly payment rates for personal care for self-funders rises from £193.50 to £212.85, and the nursing care component will rise from £87.10 to £95.80. It's estimated this will cost around £15 million in the next financial year, and it will be fully funded by additional provisions within the local government settlement as outlined in the recent 22-23 Scottish budget. The most recent official stats that we have show that over 10,000 self-funders receive free personal and nursing care payments. They should all benefit from these changes. And with that, Convener, I'm happy to take any questions that you or the committee may have.
Thank you. I'll just look to my colleagues to see if there's anyone who has any questions. I don't believe anyone does. Okay, move on to the next agenda item, which is, you know, procedurally we have to have a formal debate on this affirmative SSI. I don't see that anyone wants to make a contribution, but there is the opportunity if anyone wants to say anything. No? Okay, so I'll put the question on the motion. The question is that motion S6M03001 be approved. Are we all agreed? We're all agreed. And that concludes the consideration of this instrument. Thank you. At our next meeting on the 22nd of February, the committee will receive an update from key stakeholders on tackling alcohol harms, and will also take evidence from the Cabinet Secretary for Health and Social Care on two affirmative SSIs. And that concludes the public part of our meeting today. Thank you all.